More and more, that weather pattern starting to resemble El Nino. That's going to be what we're chatting about today in this Weather Watch. Matt Makens here. I hope this finds you well.
So the outlook for June spreads moisture from the central and southern plains through the Rockies, mostly central and northern Rockies, and also the Great Basin. Driest areas for mostly the upper Midwest, northern plains, back east. This looks an awful lot like what we just went through in May, doesn't it? Here I'm showing you what happened in May in terms of the percent of average. Really favored the southern plains right through the eastern plains of Colorado into the northern Rockies and also a touch out to the west.
But this kind of orientation where we start to see that water building up across the lee side of the Rockies, especially over the plains, that's at least a visual clue or a weather clue, if you will, that El Nino's trying to kick in.
To illustrate this point, is the El Nino summer shown here. It's an analysis that I ran where I grabbed El Nino summer since 1990. Why didn't I use years prior to 1990? I want to capture the similar ocean oscillations in addition to El Nino. That would include the Pacific, a term PDO may be familiar to you. The Atlantic is another concern, the AMO. Perhaps you've heard of these things. As the PDO and AMO play with El Nino, that varies the precipitation across the country. I want to capture the most recent 30 years, so that's why I started since 1990. And you can see this orientation here versus May's precipitation and the June outlook are very similar, aren't they? But this analysis did any kind of El Nino. We are not technically in an El Nino just yet, more on that in a moment, and we have a varied strength of El Ninos to consider here. So let's break it down, weak versus strong El Nino. Yeah.
Let's just focus on a weak El Nino because we don't have a strong El Nino just yet. So out of the weak solution, we have wetter than normal conditions across the plains, mostly the central plains, and out across the Great Basin, perhaps portions of the Pacific Northwest, but mostly that would be along the Cascades and east of, and then also for the northern Rockies into the northern high plains. That's when we have a weak El Nino in place. And as we go back to that image of the precipitation map, that is starting to look a bit more El Nino-like. So El Nino, is it here yet? Technically, no, although the weather pattern is starting to look more and more like El Nino. We have the ocean conditions here and where we look for El Nino in these boxes highlighted here. It's not the entire ocean. It's just this region right in here, the ENSO region. When warm water is here, indicated by the red colors, red being warmer than average, when that area of ocean is warm, that's classically when we start to see El Nino conditions. But the technical textbook definition, if you want to bury it that deeply, is we need 3 consecutive months where these areas of ocean are warmer than average by 0.5 degrees Celsius. That's the technical definition. So we're not technically in El Nino yet. It hasn't been officially declared, but it is ahead.
So technically, no, we are not in El Nino, and there are other definitions out there which rely on the atmosphere behaving like El Nino in addition to the oceans. I think we're starting to see the atmosphere behave a bit more El Nino, as you can see in the recent precipitation and that outlook for June. Going forward, however, El Ninos are classically known as, you know, the wet weather producers. But we still have problems across the plains.
Still some work to do in terms of the soil moisture, though, across those central plains. Still much drier than average soils here, but with the outlook looking up, conditions will gradually improve. But as I've said before, patience. Pump the brake a little bit. It's going to take some time.
Pump the brake is right, especially because June outlook and the outlook for summers in weak El Ninos do not favor a lot of precipitation as you go off to parts of those plains or parts of the Corn Belt, the Midwest, etc. So we've got to watch out the forecast very carefully before we get too excited that El Nino is kicking in. El Nino has varied impacts across the country. It's not an immediate drought buster. It takes several seasons of spreading the moisture around based on El Nino's favored times to deliver precip based on different months to different regions and things. I do have optimism that we're turning the corner on the widespread drought across the country and eliminating that La Nina deficit and starting to turn the corner into a newer direction. So my optimism stems from what happened in May, what happens in early June, the outlook for June, and the possible connection to an El Nino pattern kicking in here. But I just said, pump the brakes. El Nino isn't officially declared yet. In my last video, I gave you 2 different forecasts of when El Nino will be officially declared.